Now, the big supermarkets are officially on notice. The Albanese government launching a review of the Food and Grocery Code of Conduct to try and combat soaring prices at the checkout.
But will all this actually work? To tell us more, to find out, we're joined by the man leading this review, Craig Emerson in Adelaide. Craig, good morning to you. Good to see you. Why is this essential?
Well, obviously, there's cost of living pressure on everyday Australians. Whenever they go into the supermarkets, they get a shock at the price rises. It's good to see, by the way, that Coles has now announced that they're going to reduce prices on 300 items. Hopefully that's as a result of the sorts of pressure that is being exerted by the community and through the government. So this review was actually contemplated way back in 2015 when a voluntary code of conduct was agreed between the supermarkets and their suppliers. And it's therefore this has to happen anyway, but it's a really good time for it to happen. And of course, Prime Minister Albanese has said that all options are on the table, and that is the case. We'll see what we can do to increase competition and to put downward pressure on those prices.
Well, you mentioned the Coles announcement yesterday. They've already slashed prices for beef steaks and lamb chops by more than 20% just after the Prime Minister announced your appointment. Does that show that the supermarket giants are a bit scared about this?
Well, I think they should be anxious about the fact that those meat prices that you're talking about at the farm gate have been really low, because there has been a glut of, you know, particularly sheep, but the prices at the supermarket haven't gone down or not gone down much. As a result of that, the profits have increased. So I think it is a worthwhile thing for prime ministers and the community, your show, to put pressure on these supermarkets, but in addition to that, to have more competition where we can. Now, Aldi, when I was competition policy minister in 2010, was barely a presence in Australia. Now it's got about 11% of the market. Mm. So if there are ways of bringing in new competitors, and I'm sure your viewers would say, yeah, I've been to Aldi, they are increasing their presence in the main shopping areas, not just out in the boondocks, and that is having a positive effect. And as we know, in life, in sport, competition brings out the best in us. So I, as former competition policy minister, I think that's going to be very important.
You want to make sure that Coles is legit and it's not just crafty PR, right? The current code of conduct.
I think that's right.
So yeah, the current code.
I agree with you. I mean,
sorry.
You go.
Craig, the current code is voluntary right now. Are you going to make it mandatory?
Yep. Well, it would be wrong for me to say now, early in the review, this is the outcome of the review, but that is one of the options that Anthony Albanese, the Prime Minister, is saying is on the table, moving from a voluntary to a mandatory code. You know, there's other options such as ACCC oversight. The ACCC is the Competition Consumer Watchdog, actually actively looking at the behaviour of the supermarkets, their pricing behaviour. So there is a range of options that we will consider. We'll follow the evidence rather than come up with a preconceived conclusion, but I can say that there are options, and as Anthony Albanese said, they're all on the table.
Craig, you've been around politics a long time. There'll be cynics who say that governments like to announce inquiries and reviews when they're just trying to buy some time or look like they're doing something. Can you guarantee us that we're going to see a drop in grocery prices as a result of this?
Well, that's a very,
cynical?
An understandable question, but to I thought of that word and I thought, I won't say cynical, but, you know, like, can you guarantee that there'll be good weather tomorrow? Can you guarantee this? Can you? And then if I say, no, I can't guarantee it, refuse to rule out and on, away we go. Let's just follow the evidence. Let's bring more competitive pressure and scrutiny onto the supermarkets where we possibly can. This review actually was contemplated way back in 2015. So the timing works really well, but it is a bit cynical to say, oh, well, Albanese just announced this review because he was under pressure. It was contemplated in the voluntary code of conduct that the previous government put in place. So the previous government, now in opposition, shouldn't be so cynical about it either.
So no cynicism or tricky question here, Craig. You can't guarantee prices will go down, but do you think they will?
Well, I think that the inflation itself, the inflation rate is starting to fall. We saw that with some figures that were out just yesterday. Hopefully that'll be confirmed at the end of the month when they look at the three monthly figures rather than one monthly figure. And so we do seem to be heading in the right direction, but we can't really say that there'll be deflation, that is, prices will fall all around Australia.
Angus, you have been critical of the government's priorities, but does this show that they're doing something right?
Well, prices continue to go up sharply, almost double the target rate. And of course, that's prices for almost everything, but particularly insurance, bread, milk, gas, electricity. We're continuing to see sharp price hikes. And that's on top of big increases in mortgage payments and, of course, big increases in taxes being paid, almost 27% increase in income taxes being paid by Australians. So there's a lot of pain out there, Joe. This is sure not the end of it. There's some way to go. And we do need to see a government that doesn't just mouth making this a priority but actually does it. The Prime Minister said this was going to be a priority last year. It clearly wasn't. It does need to be a priority this year.
Well, we know, John, since this announcement, Coles has reacted immediately, slashing the price of beef and lamb. Do you think this is going to be effective?
It needs to be effective. Let's get it all in perspective. Cost of living is the big problem facing Australia at the moment, and those of us with mortgages have endured pains for some 11 rate rises over the past 18 months. Now, what we'll see in the next few days, I suspect, is both the government and the Reserve Bank taking credit for the fact that it's finally started to come down, because the whole strategy of putting interest rate rises up, is to curtail inflation. So now it's finally working. As an Australian who's feeling the pinch, I don't care who takes credit. I just want it to happen. We've seen our mortgages go up now for a year and a half, 2 years. It's about time inflation came down. It's about time the strategy worked. And it's about time those prices that you talk about at the supermarket started becoming more affordable.
There are finally signs it seems the rental crisis might be easing somewhat, with new data out today showing inflation falling faster than expected, and hopefully we'll see that reflected in some much-needed interest rate cuts.
Here to tell us more is Domain's Chief of Research and Economics, Dr. Nicola Powell. Good morning to you, Nicola. How will falling inflation impact the property market?
Very good morning, Jane. Look, inflation is falling and it's falling faster than what was forecast. And that does mean the RBA's hands are going to be tied next month and we're likely to see that cash rate on hold. But most importantly, what we have seen is the market is now pricing in cash rate cuts, one in August and one in December. That will improve borrowing capacity. It will likely bring more people to market. And what we're likely to see this year is greater rates of growth towards the end of the calendar year once we start to see the cash rate being cut.
Hey, Nicola, we're hearing more about this new data from Domain, which seems to indicate that rental price growth has slowed across several capital cities. What can you tell us?
Absolutely. So this is probably the news that tenants have been waiting for. What we found over the combined capital cities is house rents held steady for the first time in almost 3 years. So let's remember this follows 10 consecutive quarters of rent hikes for house rents across the combined capitals. And these conditions are being mirrored across Melbourne, both for houses and for units, and also units in Sydney. We still have some capital cities posting growth. Perth is still seeing strong rates of growth, but what I would say, most of our capital cities are now seeing slower rates of growth, moving away from those extreme conditions that we were seeing.
So what are the current rental prices across the caps?
So even though we have seen a slowing down of growth, we've got to remember that we've got record high rents across most of our capital cities. Across the combined capitals, it's at a record high, both for houses and for units, and that's at $600 a week. Most of our capital cities do have record rents. That is apart from Canberra houses and also units in Hobart and Darwin. And we've seen a bit of a shake-up in the affordability stakes as well, Jane. We've got Melbourne, which seems a bit unbelievable that Melbourne is the most affordable capital city in which to rent a house at $550 a week, and for the cheapest unit, you've got to head to Adelaide.
Still though, Nicola, driving around Melbourne last weekend, I saw lines of people waiting to inspect rental properties. What's the future look like for the rental market, especially this year in 2024?
So what we are seeing is stretched affordability is really leaning into the rental market. I think we're seeing more people opt for house shares. And over 2023, we actually saw investors come back into the market. What we're expecting for this year is that those factors are still going to play out, but we are anticipating 2024 is going to be much better for tenants compared to the previous couple of years. There's also first home buy incentives, new ones that are going to come into place this year. And of course, as we discussed earlier, the potential for rate cuts. This is going to be good news for those tenants looking to transition to being a homeowner.
So what does it mean for renters? Will more of them become homeowners?
Hopefully so. That's what we are predicting this year. There's the Help to Buy scheme from the federal government, which should help more people transition to being homeowners. And Queensland government, they doubled their first home buyer grant. It's gone from $15,000 up to $30,000. So I will pick that Queensland will probably see an influx of first home buyer activity. But those still in the rental market, what we're likely to see is much better conditions over 2024. And what tenants will be finding at the moment is there is a little bit more choice available.
That is good news. Dr. Nicola Powell, thank you.